plumbing has been installed in the commodities trench at Massey's, ship static fire equipment readied for ship 38 at Sanchez, the new test article B18.3 sections moved into Megabay 1 at the build site, and Booster 15 completes a static fire in preparations for Flight 11 at the launch site. Hey everyone, Jeff A here, and welcome to RGV Aerial Photography's Starbase Flyover update number 97. The rapid pace of work here at Starbase Texas continues this week across the entire facility. So for now, let's kick back and start over at Massey's test facility. Before we begin, here's a labelled map from Proky to find your way around the site. Beginning at the electrical bunker, we can see transformers are being installed in the side extension of the building, where walls are being formed. At the commodities trench, all the commodity and high pressure lines are being installed, and at the purge and isolation bunker, valve panels have been installed in the left and right aisles, and in the middle, racks of pipes have been installed. A blast wall is beginning to be constructed to further protect the methane side of the tank farm from any further anomalies. Moving to the methane farm, the two valve skids that were staged last week have been installed, as well as one methane pump. To the left, piping for two more methane subcoolers has been installed, further increasing the cooling capacity. A new foundation for an additional vertical tank has been prepared, with rebar being constructed for it to the right. Proceeding to the liquid oxygen tank farm, a fan box for the nitrogen exhaust of the subcooler has been installed. Shifting to the new liquid oxygen pump setup, additional pump mounts were installed, as well as its adjacent valve skid. Now if we go over to the can crusher, six new hydraulic pistons have been installed to apply force to a test article, but it's currently unclear what these will be simulating. Finally, formwork for what is believed to be a new electrical building seems to be nearing completion, with a pour expected by the next episode. That's it for Massey's, let's move to Sanchez. Starting at the transport stands area, the new stand parts have been assembled. Nearby, four legs that will be installed under it are staged. Our speculation is that it could be for payload bays, as it has this structure in the middle with a similar size to the PEZ dispenser, and two holes for easier access. This should be used to move them to Megabay 2 and Gigabay in the future. The ring wall is getting prepared to be moved to the launch site ahead of Ship 38 static fire. Here we can see the BQD and SQD adapter. It was moved to the pad on Monday 8th to be installed again. Three hoods for the hold-down arms have been moved from near the inventory tent. These will be installed on Pad 2's OLM to cover the hold-down clamps from the booster exhaust. Link arms that may be associated with these are still in storage near the inventory tent. To the side of the SQD arm, two ladder-shaped structures are being assembled, and it's unclear if these are related to the arm or not. Additional cable trays have been installed near the backup power plant. It appears this may be to add more generator trailers to the backup system while the main plant continues to be worked on. Finally, marking next to the new Tesla Megapacks indicates two more to be installed. Just before moving to the build site, we'd like to thank all of our YouTube and Patreon members. Remember, all of the patrons get to participate in our Discord show and tell sessions on the same day of each flight. Here you can join in the discussions and ask your own questions. YouTube members also get to watch and listen in with a live chat function. Let's start off a tour of the build site this week with the Star Factory, where two sections of Booster 18.3 were moved to Megabay 1. B18.3 is a Starship Super Heavy Block 3 prototype, with its most notable feature being this interstage replacing Block 2's bulky hot staging ring, which will no longer have to be detached after stage separation. It'll also help a ton in terms of mass savings on the booster, helping Starship version 3 get up to 100 tons into low Earth orbit. On September 6th, another RVAC engine was seen entering Megabay 2, indicating engine installation hasn't been completed yet on Ship 38. Now looking at the Gigabay, three more sections of pile cap have been poured, or are in the process of being poured with concrete over the past 2 weeks. Moving next to Megabay 2, we can see some access platforms being assembled for installation in Megabay 1. At Megabay 1, we saw a booster transport stand move into the bay on the 5th of September, and Booster 15 was lifted onto it before rollout to the launch site for static fire testing. More on B15 later. Moving north to Boca Chica Village, we can see that additional prefabricated concrete units have been built. And a quick stop at the Rio West development, we can see that housing construction is progressing rapidly. Before moving on to the launch site, a quick reminder to leave a like if you've learned something new from this video. Here's this week's labelled map. Take a moment to pause the video if you need extra time looking it over. Starting at the corner of pad 2, forms have been removed from the retention wall. Along the edge of the pad, new forms are being installed to create a curb to direct runoff into the pond. At the GSE bunker, cladding installation continues. The large gap on the right wing is seen covered to the second level, with above and to the right installed since the flyover. In the middle section, panels on the second level are installed on the left, with matching panels on the right later installed. Two pipes can be seen in the gap on the left side. These are connected to the flange pipes at the first level ceiling. It's unclear if these are vents out of the bunker or if they are connected to the purge system and will be connected to additional pipework behind the cladding. The last two trench walls have been installed, completing all four corners. Looking just above, the stabilisation arms have now been installed on the tower 2 chopsticks. The deluge water farm has been quiet this week, though further progress has been made for the blast wall along the eastern end. Behind the LR11000, yet another concrete slab has been poured, bringing the launch site closer to completion. The mega bunker frame is largely assembled, with the remaining floor and roof decking being installed. The roof also has rebar being laid in preparation of a poured concrete roof. The Pad 2 pump farm is still waiting on the final methane pump assembly to arrive. Final pipe connections have been made to fully integrate the methane distribution to the main commodities trench. At the front of the tank farm, rebar has been prepared to where the vertical LOX tanks were recently removed. Embeds suggest that replacement tanks or additional vaporizers will soon be installed. Across the street, the air separation unit construction continues. More of the concrete walls have been finished. The eastern perimeter piles have also been excavated in preparation of further progress. All the CFA drill equipment has been removed from the site. Most of it has left Starbase, though the drill rig itself still remains parked at the entrance to the hoppy lot. At Pad 1, final preparations are being made for Flight 11 testing to commence. The scaffolding on the dance floor has been packed up. On September 6th, Booster 15.2 would be transported to the launch site ready for a static fire attempt on the 7th. SpaceX would post videos of what is confirmed to be a successful test. The booster would swiftly return to the build site, and the work on the OLM would immediately turn to the installation of the ship testing hardware for Ship 38. Monday the 8th would see the installation of the SQD pipe frame, and the SQR ship adapter would be moved to the launch site later in the week. Well, that's it for episode 97 of Starbase Flyover Update. Thanks for choosing to fly with RGV Aerial Photography, and we hope you all enjoyed the flight. If you liked what you saw today, please do subscribe for more episodes and content, and so you don't miss out on the new videos each week. I'm Jeff A, and we'll see you again from 6,000 feet.